I want to tighten it down with the drill, but I want them straight up and down because that slot goes like that. So I want this straight up and down the wing. Drill won't fit in there. Let's see. Lots of other ends, though. Got some very long ones. I got a long ways to go. You want to see, I had one of these in here, and that's just too big. This part won't go in there. So if this will go far enough, then maybe I'll get it. Longer screwdriver, I think. Let's see if this chin locks will fit in there. I've got a bar. Yeah, I didn't mention it's spinning. It's not hitting anything. So, and I know it was not tight on there, so I don't think it's crossed through. Thank you. see if this one will work. Well, 4 hours putting the grill on, 5 minutes to get it off. 5 minutes to 10 minutes, 20 minutes to fix the horn. Once I figured out the simplest, did what I finally should have done in the day one and took it off. Look at it. this one started on the bottom and I didn't. Maybe I can get that magnet. That magnet held it straight well enough for me to put the magnet on it like that, and that held it straight. So if I can do that, that's sharp, so we can do something to make it a little less sharp. I'll put a little tape on it, I guess. I don't think taping it to my finger, I can get my left hand in there that way better than I could my right hand on the other one. I can't believe that. I must have had it. Sometimes this will turn and you look, the bolt will go right up in the between there and you'll think you got it. But usually it starts getting really tight and you know, you just feel that it's not working right. Yeah, I stuck my finger in there like a dummy and turned the drill on. And of course, my finger couldn't stand up to that. So it hurt. It just spun like crazy and hurt. So don't do what I do. Okay, now. I can't believe I gotta put this one on there now. I thought I had it on. It was the last one I was worried about because I thought it was already started. I've got the rest of them snugged up. Just beginning to snug up. Top one's actually fairly well snugged up, but I can always loosen it if I need to. But I don't need to. I got lots of play with the bolts. Big old slots that they go through. I'm going to try taping this one to my finger and use the magnet to hold the little nut straight. Maybe that'll do it. But I'll use a screwdriver to get it started. I will not use a drill. Of course, you wouldn't do that anyway, but not unless you want to strip it out. Okay. Yeah, so you know all these nice people who edit out these videos. This is what you would see if it wasn't edited for you. Hours of bullshit. But you know, if you don't give up, you can usually, most of the time, succeed. Ah, okay, that's not taped on there very good, but that's okay. As long as it'll keep it from I can press that way and it won't spin because of the tape, and I can hold it out over and try to get it started. Oh, the magnet. It's helping and hurting both. We kept pulling the thing off to the wrong spot, you know, from where I wanted it to be. But I did finally get it. I started to try to take the magnet off, but it was holding it straight, you know, the head of the little bolt. After all that, I think I could have just taped regular bolts to my fingers and done a better, easier job of it. But you would have to have giant washers and everything else in there. You'd have to cut the sides up, flatten one side off so that it would go up into that, you know, that channel and still grab something. Yeah, anyway, on and on. So this is what I did. Get a drink. I'm gonna drink right quick. Just about a teaspoon of creamer in my coffee. And the coffee's kind of a sweet bean anyway. So anyway, I've been drinking on my coffee all day. It's been cold all day since this morning. And water. I need some energy. But I've almost got that. So I'm going to try to go ahead and tighten this up. And then I'll be done and I can just pick up. Get me some snack of some sort and pick up after that. So just get the drill. Good, and I think, yeah, the way I set the clutch on the drill is about drill actually saved me. My hands are so tired of turning that screwdriver that I couldn't hardly turn it anymore. So that's it. It's tighter than it's probably been for years. It's got four good secure connections there, all four corners and the centers. They spin pretty easy. They don't snug up really. But put that back over there until I'm ready. But they'll keep it from rattling. I don't know, but I finding that extra, maybe that one had fell out way earlier and I just now found it. Maybe it was off the left side bottom, because that other one that I showed you that was broke was off the bottom right, I believe. Sorry. So let's take the camera over there if I can, and I'll show you what I've done the best I can. Thank you. Okay. I am worn out now, especially since I need to eat so much, so badly now. Okay, there's the screw. And I don't think I can show you the, I can't show you the wing. I can't really see them either. What is it? Can't even find my spot. Go out and then go back in. There, okay. Up in there, there's a wing bolt. Oh, you can see the shininess of the, I'm holding it so funky. Because of the cord, the problem with the cord dangling and trying to break things. Okay, there's the shiny, that's that long, the wing nut screwed all the way back up to the back, and I got them fairly straight. Finally gave up on getting them perfectly straight. They just wasn't gonna happen. So, as long as they're grabbing, that's what matters. But, and then the ones in the center, I can't feel, that stuff's wide. That's the deal with it. The whole hood latch and everything, and I can't, that's so wide, I can't reach back there and even feel and see if that plastic is missing or not on either one of them, but the screws aren't falling out, they're just not tightening up, which is not. That's why I went to so much trouble, because I knew that plastic is old, 1976 old, and I've had it since 92, and I've never replaced any of them, and now the grill's not, I mean, it's solid now. It may be in there way too solid, because those may be really heck to get out if I ever need to, but that'll move, but where is it? Oh, that's because I was pulling over there away from the screw. So, oh, the horn and the voltage, all that stuff. I still want to know about that. Do I want to go ahead and do it now? Kind of do. How am I going to do that? If I can set that where I want to do is see the voltage. I don't know if I can show it by putting the camera over this way. Oops, I'm doing it again. I guess you can see it. Well, that thing will flex the one with those rubber bands. Okay, so if I put the camera from here somehow, I think that might work. Is it still running? Yeah. Okay. Okay, now I may need a little light. Anything weird like that. Just want to see if I'll get the light we need in that area. Yeah. Yeah. Didn't help. Something makes it where I can see. There we go. How's that? Now that might actually help me. Not shining in my face. Anything go funky on the camera. I don't know why it's not working. It certainly looks. Go down some more. Ah, there we go. What's yellow? Oh, that's looking really super yellow. Okay. Breaking the bulb. Okay, let's make the hot spark. Let's see. What? you do it with no light whatsoever. This is a weird time of day, I guess, for doing this. Maybe it's better than it looks in the preview. I mean, it looks like it should work. Well, they're not shining so much at the camera, maybe. Nope. Okay. Well, that's the best I guess I can do. Let me get my jumper wire. Voltmeter. Yeah, it doesn't really matter. If it's laying on its side, at least it'll give me a reading and I can kind of see. I'll try it without the vice grips on it first. And it's grounded, so I don't need a jumper for the ground. Well, I need this to be grounded. Okay. Okay. See, what I'm thinking is I didn't get a reading because it wasn't grounded. The horn wasn't grounded. And of course, that's why it wasn't honking. So if I ground my meter, been grounded. I scratched the paint off with those hooks enough times. Now let's turn it on. Let's see. The meter kind of out of the picture. There it is. Gonna be, I don't know if it can be seen at all, but anyway, it's hunting right now. But I can see. I'll hunt the horn. But I can't see. I could have to hold it down for a long time for that to read. But I do believe the test light would force to do. I did that. We could do the test light again. Instead of trying to poke it in the hole, well, actually, yeah, let's do that. That way I'll know if my little lead on the is even making a connection. I'll just put it up here and hook it up. Now, if I can do it without it falling, nothing to the wild blue wonder. When you stand there. There we go. Now that should make that come on. Should see a little light. Didn't see no light. Okay, so maybe that's why my meter didn't do nothing. Because I didn't really get a connection out of that. Well, I guess I should have used the, This is where I did it last time. I should have used the vice grips, I guess. I guess I'll try putting them on there. That's the only way I'm going to know that I'm getting a good connection on there. If I squeeze it down tight. There, now that should be getting a connection. I also stuck it where the pin, teeth looked a little longer. Okay. Yeah, that's some good. There we go. White. Okay. Now let's keep this away from everything. We'll try the voltmeter again. I don't see any way to get it in there. Standing up. So let's pick the voltmeter up. Managed to, just a little walking trip there, I managed to tangle those cords up just a very little bit. So yeah, when you're making tests, if you don't have a good connection, your test is no good. Well, I guess you gotta be really careful about that, don't you? Fool yourself all day long. Now, probably we'll just keep hunting until it gets a signal. Honey, it says negative. Okay, let's try that. It definitely sees the signal. I suppose if I was watching the video, I might be able to freeze it. I don't want to honk the horn forever. Rather a bit of crazy in the neighborhood. But yeah, it's giving a signal now, as it wasn't before. So that's why, that's the great mystery of why the multimeter read nothing in my previous tests, because I had no ground. The horn was so corroded, the wire was so corroded, the power wasn't barely getting to the horn, but the ground was so bad that it couldn't work but once in a while. You know, I guess it would get that first burst of, you know, electric energy, but then it couldn't break it again, and it may stop trying when it, if it's too much current going through it, so that you don't burn everything up. It may do that, I don't know. Spotted mule, or whatever they like to say about how hot you are. I'm hot. I'm tired. But I still have a horn, and I got my. Oh, and I've got still wired up. I've got my. See, I'm dangling this all over the place. Here. But that's what keeps it going all this long periods of time like this. Okay, so this is what I'm dragging around today. Okay, so that's good. This is Friday night. This is my night out. Out in the yard working on the truck. Okay, so, haven't been out and gone anywhere in years. Anyway, literally, this truck's been broken. I haven't been able to go anywhere. And my van is, it runs, but it needs work too. But this was leaking gas. I couldn't drive it. And now it's not. And put that fuel hose in there, that fuel transfer tube. Did a little battery melting when I energized my, magnetized my screwdrivers. Okay, so I believe everything works now. I tested my parking brake yesterday. So it should I leave my bathroom rug in there? I don't think so, it'll get dirty fast. Save it for the next time I need to work on something. So it's working. I just gotta put up everything. But I'm gonna have a snack. That looks to me like somebody who really needs a snack. But all I see is a camera there. Oh well. Anyway. I used to, you know, when I would go camping, I'd use just a shade by in the morning. Pretty good mirrors. So, I got everything under the sun out in here. You see, my drills and all my grinding stuff that I could have used, you know, was down in there and I didn't want to dig it out. So, did it on the minimalist amount of tools today. If I had a nice big shop like I'd like to have, or if I didn't have to save so much junk, and if I didn't have no junk, what would I work on? But anyway, that's another day. Alright, I'm done. Yeah, I went falling and yanking on the cords. Let it go everywhere. Okay, so I'm done. And now, next thing I have to do is go get that tire, spare tire, put on the ground, and I'll use my one that's a different brand. My BF Goodrich will be my spare, and then I'll have all the same brand on the ground. And I'll do that the same place, the tire place where I usually go to get inspected. So it's been a couple of years, I guess, since I've been there, but as long as they're still doing it. Okay. And this is a 76, so all it needs is a safety inspection in Texas, so it should be all right. You know, as long as all the blinkers, lights, and brakes work and everything. I haven't driven it, so I'm see how, you know, all that is. But before, and I got windshield wipers. I got to get some windshield wipers. I was thinking about ordering them, but, you know, then I'd be waiting on them. I'd probably just go get some and then go from there to the, you can put them on in the parking lot of the auto store. As long as, I just didn't want to do it in the sun, but in the heat, because sometimes it doesn't take 2 minutes, it takes 10 or 15 just because something didn't go right. That, and I have to have something. Well, I got a little step ladder. I don't know if you saw it just now. It's in the back seat right now. It used to be back in the back where I put that tire. I put it in the back seat temporarily. I'll have to use that step ladder to get up there, really. I mean, you can kind of climb up on the tires and stuff. I'm more liable to fall now. And I used to never have, didn't have a ladder in it. You know, I didn't need it when I was younger. But, anyway, yeah, so I guess I'll make another little end-up video. I don't think I'll try to make any videos while I'm, you know, out doing all that, but probably just like how it went kind of video. All right, just done, and thanks for watching, like they always say, and I'm sure if you watch it, any of this, you'll skip through, but that's good. That's